There are many stories that I try to tell when I make a Let's Play series, and sometimes they pay off, sometimes they play out, and other times they just don't, through one reason or another. A mod fails, a corruption of the save file, save game bloat, what have you. There's a number of reasons why a series never reaches my intended conclusion. Typically when I create a character, I kinda see that where their path is going to go, and I have an idea on how it's supposed to end. And in Breathes Fire's case, there was a lot more planned than was executed. Turning him into a live stream series became a matter of necessity simply because of Requiem's chaotic and sporadic nature of where should I go next? I don't know. And that made it really hard to tell a story. Breathes Fire was always supposed to finish defeating Alduin. Stop the vampires with the Dawn Guard, yes. Stop Mirak, yes. But then, go and defeat Alduin, and that's it. End credits. Doing the live stream stopped that, mostly because the Soul Cairn was impossible, and the Dragonborn DLC was far easier than I expected. And Alduin was easier than the Soul Cairn, though he had his own difficulties. And it would have made for a very poor conclusion to a story to have died repeatedly over and over and over again. Even though he was never intended to actually go through with the fight, what I had planned was a massive machinima-style ending. Totally cinematic. Camera angles, mods made specifically to pull off certain scenes, and a final goodbye and a perfect send-off for the hero of Skyrim. So that's what this series is. I probably should have started with what the series is, just in case you haven't made it this far. This is The Never Was of Breathes Fire. The song you are about to hear is Doomsday by Murray Gold, made famous by the show Doctor Who. It was intended to be included in the cinematic piece for pacing and more dramatic effect. It is included here for pacing, and so it may help you visualize more of what was being done. Alduin approaches on land. A hard-fought battle ensuing as he continually takes off and lands, takes off and lands, and there seems to be no stopping him. But Breathes Fire knows of only one way. To his best friend Inigo and says, "I'm sorry." Inigo, a look of fear on his face.
"No, my friend, please."
Using voice snippets. Breathes Fire quickly turning back around.
"Force Roda!"
Knocking Inigo as far away as he possibly can. Turning back towards Alduin, now staring at him, he slowly approaches. Alderaan's neck rears back, his mouth open wide, about to chomp down on Breathe's fire. As Breathe's fire himself starts summoning a master level fire spell. Alduin lurches down, swallowing Breathe's fire whole, swallowing him in a gulp. Inigo from the background.
No!
Suddenly, Alduin erupts. Breathe's fire, master level fire spell, erupting within Alduin's belly. Alduin thrashes back and forth in agony.
No!
As he agonizingly dies in pain. The shockwave destroying the Whale Bridge. The dragon is dead. The world is saved. But Inigo, kneeling by where he fell from Breathe's fire's blast, he looks to the heavens, the sea, the staff of Magnus, slowly fallen from the heavens, clattering uselessly on the ground. The last remains of the wizard lizard who gave his life to save the world. Cut to various scenes of Breathe's fire's past, meeting Lydia, befriending Inigo, joining the College of Winterhold. Relaxing at home. Cut to the companions who hold a huge memorial pyre. Cut to the college, where the mages are firing their staffs into the air in honor of their fallen archmage. Cut to Windhelm, where a huge stone statue of the hero they never wanted lay, making testimony that you don't need to be Nord to be the best for Skyrim.